Off. Hello, everybody. Happy Monday night. Thanks for coming in. I'm happy you guys are here. Thank you so much. Hi. So welcome in, everybody. We've got, certainly, thank you, Diane. We've got some stuff to talk about tonight for sure. There's never a lack of content. little recap and just some reminders. So first with those, if you click on my bio, you'll see a link, couple things. You've got the Cheer Choice Award nomination, which is super awesome. Thank you, guys. And then the other one is you can find my YouTube channel. That's where we're posting all of these videos that we do or all of these lives that we do. So if you miss it, you can catch up there on the YouTube channel. And then you have my email address, too, where if you want to send a message, you just want to talk, you want to vent, anything, you're welcome to put it there. I promise I read them all and I will respond. So thank you guys for sending your messages. They've been super supportive. They've been, you know, sharing experiences, and I can't thank you guys enough for opening up, being vulnerable, and trusting me with that information, and just know that it's safe. But yesterday we had talked about I shared a lot of audio. Hi, Chris. Shared a ton of audio out there of just examples of all of this behavior that you guys have been watching for a long time now. Yes, and if you have a story, I would love to read it. And if you're wanting to share, I would love for you to be a part of this as well, because the whole goal is to support each other. We're not here to, I guess we're being called bullies, but we're really not. We're sharing information. We are providing receipts. We are telling the truth, and we're coming together. So yesterday I shared a lot of different things of what you guys have seen, messages that I've received, messages that you've heard online. That's all over the internet. You can't deny it. It's there. We have every time we come on, if there's something from my experience, I have a receipt. Anything that he said, I've got a receipt. It's right there. But we talked a lot about yesterday is this him leaving the hockey golf dad character is what he described it as, in changing all of his account names to Dan Corey. It's the same person. And it's kind of a silly move because, well, now he's putting the blame on what he called a character. But it is, when if you search the name, you're going to find a lot more information that he probably doesn't want coming up at the top of your search. So he talked about being the truth teller and a lot of different things, but I want to play, hold on, I want to pull up some of this stuff here that I have, because this happened. Wait, hold on. No, that's, hold on. See, sometimes I'm ready, sometimes I'm not. Let me go back up. It is silly, actually. It is silly. If you've been around for the past 4.5 months, you've seen what he's done. And this is just another manipulation tool. And you'll hear it. So yesterday it was the character moving on. I'm the truth teller. But this is what was said an hour ago. So listen here.
It is what it is. I guess some people get their kicks off it. They like to lie and get their kicks off on putting other people down. It's fucking
sad. I don't understand it.
I don't either. It's very sad.
Well, we can go on a
happy people would not do that. Happy people would not do that.
Well.
Shelly. And I've had my times where I've been negative, but it's never came on this app intentionally to ever just like savage people. It's weird.
Okay, we're going to stop right there. So there's your answer right there. This was like an hour ago. This is pretending to be above everything. He's angry. Yes, 100% he's angry. He has never come on this app, and I quote you, to intentionally savage someone. Okay, time out. There is your hockey golf dad, Dan Corey, that has never, Mr. Truth Teller, Mr. Authenticity, that has never come on this app to intentionally savage somebody. And us telling the truth is sad. Okay, let's go back. Me, the past 4.5 months, have been savaged on this with complete lies. Okay, let's go to Alexis Nicole. You guys saw what he put her through and continues to do so. His son, he's talked about his children, his parents, everybody that crosses him has been savaged on this app. So no, this is not healing. This is another ploy and manipulation to get people to try and like him, to send him money. Okay? And I've got plenty, trust me, plenty of examples of this. So when a new character comes out, Dan Corey, or blames it on the character Hockey Golf Dad, guys, it's all part of it. It is all part of it. Again, let me just play that part again for you, for those in the back that didn't hear it.
But it's never came on this app intentionally to ever just like savage people. It's weird.
That was like an hour ago. Okay. Lies. Lies, lies, lies. You cannot hide from it. It's your choice. Yes. Cottonwood County. Other creators. I mean, it's just insanity. But what I want to talk about tonight is a couple of things, because you just can't not talk about these things and try and figure out the whys and how to get away from it. How do you get away from it? You guys have seen the videos. I see all the comments. You've seen the videos. He savages everybody on here for his own personal gain. Like, You can't hide from that. All we're doing is telling the truth here. That's it. And he's not going to get my sympathy. Not at all. Not for the hell that he's put me and my family, my friends through. It's not going to happen. So, and I've got my notes here because I always like to do my research, have my notes so that we can talk about it. And with somebody with this type of extreme narcissism, they get away with it because those that they abuse have never ever experienced anything like it. He blasted my boss. He's never met the man. But they do it because the people that they're doing it to, they've never experienced it. What's the longest time that he's left me alone? Right now we're coming on month and a half, almost 2 months, which is great. Now that's direct contact to me. It's every day on this app right here. So the way they get away with it is because they go against people that have really never experienced anything like this in their life. And somebody like me, somebody like most people, you just can't wrap your head around it. You can't really understand how somebody could be so cruel. And how even that type of cruelty exists, you know, in this world. And then what you do is you think, okay, you start to think that something's wrong. Like, what? You think that you're going crazy and you're not. And so a couple of things that I was reading up on today is how do you avoid this kind of stuff? And I look back and I was going through old messages that he would send me. And guys, I kid you not. I mean, there's a lot of people in here that have been on the receiving end of text messages or Snapchats. And the guy never shuts up. So there's a lot to go out there. I tell you, just in 2 weeks. 2 weeks. 2 weeks. Here's all my files. And I have sticky notes, the ones that the judge was the most curious about. Yeah, you got to scroll fast to get through those snaps if you even pay attention to them. I mean, he was even, ugh. Yeah, okay, that's 2 weeks, 498 different forms of communication. And what I don't have, I have some of it in here, but what I don't have is because I just couldn't do the snap stuff, and then his snap got taken down, so I didn't have any of that stuff. This is just straight to my phone. But thinking about how to get away from it. And I go back and I was looking through old text messages, even from early on in our relationship. I'll read you this one. This one was, and I've got it right. Whoops, I had it. Hold on. I forget that this one's a touch screen. I've got it right here, so you can see. It's from Dan Corey, and these are the texts here. It says, you'll like this. It says, I honestly don't know if it's PTSD from the past few months. Now, this was May 2nd of this year. Don't know if it's PTSD from the past few months or what, but when people like Crystal come in, and I don't know who he's referring to, and make it personal, I just don't like being on anymore. And he's referring to being on TikTok. I get enough hate and that I don't need people taking battles / games that seriously. Huh. I thought that's what his job was. And that they need to make a statement as well as to be rude to me when I go live with them, aka Crystal. I'm just tired of being portrayed as the villain on the app. I've bled for and given up relationships at times with my kids. That was in May, right? And then you block people if they don't tap the screen that he is bled for. That's how seriously he takes this app. Let's see. I want to, hold on. There was a really good one that I had. Hold on. I was organized. I promise I was. He's wanted to be the villain on this app because he thought he would be one of the cool guys by being a villain on this app. Okay. Here is Another text message. So again, this was, I don't even know why I got this message. But again, I've got it right here. So if you guys want proof, it's from Dan Corey. And this is a message to me on July 2nd. And it says, I will make sure your name, and this is all in capital letters, never mentioned again to anyone ever in my life. Promise, period. Not a word online or in text, period. You are officially dead to me. Go enjoy your old life. That was July 2nd. And my response was, this is sad. Is this what it is at this point? That was my response to him. Yeah. That wasn't good. So other things. Let's see. Oh, here's another one. What's this? See? It's not hard to find, guys. I have 498 of these in 2 weeks. Okay? So another message. You saw it's from Dan Corey. It says, this was July 29th, so this was not long after I had left. It says, I promise I will try to not ever text again. I won't promise perfection, but please understand you were my best friend. I'm very confused in my head, and I am sorry for that. I want you happy, and I go be sad because you are a better person, Jen, than me. And I am sorry I did not notice. I'm not nice sometimes. I didn't know. Okay. But right before that, the message was, again, got it here. I deactivated TikTok. So again, he's just obsessed with TikTok. Please remember our amazing times together and give me some time. I promise I'm trying to do the right thing, but with a fucked up brain and feeling abandoned, I don't know what the right thing even is. That is why I don't understand why you don't talk to me. You promise not to abandon me, in capital letters. So again, it's that twist. It's that flip of, first it was, I'll deactivate TikTok because that's what you want. Please allow me some time to fix my fucked up brain. But you promise never to abandon me, okay? It's that type of manipulation that makes you question your own sanity because it's all in the same sentence. It's in the same breath. And it just continues. I mean, look at the length of these messages. And again, I have not responded in weeks. And then it says, I don't understand. Oh, you'll like this. I don't understand how you are not proud of me when I try every day just to do the right thing. Again, I'm not responding. Not responding. By then, by this date, as he's sending these messages, I was already in the process of going before a judge to get the protection order. Now, it took a couple of days for them to find him and serve him for the sheriff's department to hand it to him. So this was the time where the messages kept coming through. I'd already gone through the courts. The judge had issued at the time, the temporary restraining order, and then the sheriff had to serve him. Now, what he was doing at that time was dipping out of the house and golfing or driving around or doing something. So it took a couple of days for the sheriff to do it, but they were able to do it. And then that's when he stopped because he got that notice, and then we had to appear in court within 14 days. Yeah, he was out scootering. They couldn't find him. And you can imagine the sheriff's department actually has other things going on. You know, they have some pretty important jobs to do. And so having to take their time and resources to go try and find Dan Corey, because my case was important and it was important to them too, but they've got other stuff, you know, to do as well. But that couple of days of just waiting, like, has he been served? Has he been served? It was agonizing. And the same thing with my sister's restraining order and with my boss's as well. When my boss got the restraining order, they kept trying to serve him. They would show up every single day trying to find him, and he would, disappear. And then we had to show up to court. And he didn't show up for that, and we were unable to serve him within that time frame, within the 14, or I think it was 12 days. And then we had to go back out, and that's when my other coworkers, were able to find him one night in the driveway and personally serve him the paperwork. And then he did not appear in court for that either. So he skipped all of it. He had every opportunity to contest it. And that time has come and gone. He chose not to appear, and they're all permanent. But anyway, so you go back to that. So it's all of these things are going on at that time. These messages are coming through. Oh, I got this one. Again, because we always have receipts. It's from Dan Corey. It says, I'll just delete TikTok, leave you and your family alone, and leave for somewhere soon, and leave you the house. We've heard that before. I can't try to get you or your entire family to fall in love with me, and I am sick of crying. Okay, same sentence. Again, yes, the gaslighting right there. And again, I'm not responding at all. It says, then he writes, I get it. You're embarrassed of me. I know I caused that. You don't think you're ever going to be able to get past it until you leave me. And then it says, and Sharon hates me. So there's that. That's my mother. Then 22 minutes later, it says, I've deactivated. If you would add me back on Snap, I'd appreciate it. All right, James, I remember that too. And then let's see, 40 minutes later or so, it says, hello, question mark. I don't want that to happen. I don't know what that means, but I don't want to be sad. What is going on? Confused now. Is it a bad cell area? Did I upset you? I don't know what's going on. Again, so that we can always show receipts here from Dan Corey. I get it now. Again, these are in the same day, guys. These are in the same day. It says, I get it now. Your family is worried that I will go off on them and I will find out that your mom messaged Alexis, and they don't want me saying shit, although, and I'm going to skip this person's name because they're not, I don't want to talk about them in this. Does your board really know anything? Does your boss? What is the truth? Who hates me and why, Jen? Again, I'm not responding. Would love to know the truth about everything so I don't go crazy speculating, especially on a live. A 2-minute phone call or even a text would really be appreciated. I don't know if that doesn't blow your mind. And then it says, I'll just delete TikTok and leave you and your family alone. That didn't happen. That didn't happen at all. But you like that? Would love to know the truth about everything. So I don't go crazy speculating, especially on a live. What truth? I don't know what he's asking for here. I honestly don't know. He had flipped everything around to make me the bad guy and to make him the victim. Okay. Oh, this one too. I put in a job application to the manager at the liquor store. I think we showed that application where he wrote down his experience was TikTok legend. I will fix myself to someday deserve you again, Jen. Never let any of my hurtful, shitty words make you sad. I'm a shitty human to ever say them to someone I love so incredibly much. Four and a half months now. What's the question here? Are you talking about because you're trying to warn people or get back at him? No, no. We're trying to tell the truth. I'm trying to tell the truth. How can I relive this every night? This man makes me live this every fucking day. Every single day that people support him on this platform. And so it's my turn to talk. Show the receipts, share the truth in hopes that people don't get hurt anymore. That's what we're trying to do. That's what we're trying to do. So let's kind of talk about it. Let's go back to how do we get away from that? And if I could have read this a long time ago, man. So I was reading this stuff and it says, how do you get away or how do you avoid narcissistic rage? And yeah, there's things that I probably would have done differently had I had known this. So there's a bunch of bullet points here when I'm looking these things up. And it says the first thing to do is to firmly state your boundaries and stick to them, which I believe I tried. You know, at the beginning, it was hard. Because of the back and forth and the back and forth, it's hard. Because again, I have a heart. I'm human. I have compassion. Thank you. And I genuinely care about people and I cared about him. But then I set the firm boundaries. Do not communicate with me. Do not talk to me. Do not talk to my family. Do not talk to anybody. The next thing you have to do is try and stay calm. And that is very, very hard. You know, it was multiple breakdowns and tears and anger and the urge to just savage this guy. Just savage him from the get-go. But try to stay calm. Don't overreact to their rage. That's very hard to do. They say, don't empathize with the narcissist and validate their viewpoint. That's one thing I didn't do. I did not. I didn't do it. The other thing they say to do is physically distance yourself and did that right away. Right away. Got the hell out of there. The next thing is don't raise your voice. Now, of course, there were times where we would have a disagreement or an argument and I would raise my voice. But nothing compared to how you guys see it every day on here. The other thing is they say pause and explain the issue to the narcissist. That, try doing that without either, I think Taryn described it the best as like a toddler tantrum. The next thing is to remember that it's not about you. And that, again, is very hard to do because they make it 100% about you. Oh, there you are. Okay. Hold on. They say here also understand where the fault lies. And again, that's hard to do at the beginning. I see it now. But it's very hard to do at the beginning. And then follow through on your established boundaries. And I did that. Contacted law enforcement, went the legal route, did everything right and trusted the process. So those are just some of the tips on how to avoid the rage that comes with somebody that is this type of extreme narcissist. And again, all we're doing is we're telling the truth, we provide receipts, and we're sharing examples because it's just, it's scary, guys. It's super scary. And trying to, did he fly or drive back to Minnesota? I would imagine he drove. He's scared of flying. Yeah, they do. They make you feel crazy, blame, push you to react and play the victim. You know, when he called the front desk at the Y and said, I will unalive myself if I don't talk to her. And he said that to just somebody, a person working at the front desk. Now that person has to live with that. He doesn't understand what he says and the impact that has on people. That person is traumatized because of that. He drove. He's not a good flyer. He's terrified of flying. But again, so just showing examples so that we can, well, number one, it helps me be able to talk about it and actually have a voice. Your ex used it daily. I know. It's, you guys have heard, how many times has he said that? He's even said it on his lives recently. It's just crazy. You came across this live and he blocked you? Probably. He blocked you 5 months ago? If you're not tapping or gifting. Yep. But this is good because I can actually read the comments. Usually they're going so fast I can't read any of these. So it's good to be able to read the comments. Yeah, guys, I don't know why. I don't know why. Well, yeah, this is so uncomfortable to get on here and to say it, but it is so, I don't even know the right word. I tried to describe this the other night. When you have been through this and you live this every single day, there's hate, and I've never felt hate. You know, I've never felt these types of things before in my life. And it just is like toxins inside of your body. And to let little pieces go, you start to feel just a little ounce of relief. Just a little bit at a time. And, you know, you say it's healing. It's a step for sure. But also because Dan Corey, Hockey Golf Dad, has made this so public. Thank you, Laura. Has made this so public. Every move in our relationship. And he continues to use this platform to continue this behavior. This is the perfect place to talk about it. The perfect place. Yep. Trust me, this is not to be doing. Just wanted pictures of my dogs. That was it. So yeah, great questions, you guys. And you know what? There's gonna be some hate that comes this way. I'm okay with it. I'm a big girl. I can take it. Appreciate your feedback. I'll listen to it and I'll do as I please. But yeah, I want others to be able to share because it's debilitating to live with that. And granted, our relationship was very short. It should have been just a breakup. People break up all the time. But it's been 4.5 months now of this going on every single day. Was I seeing the red flags? Yep. Did you guys hear the proposal story last night? Why was he after my job? Because it was important to me. And that's what a narcissist does, is they will go after anything that's important to you to make you be the bad person. Anything that he's ever said about my job is a bunch of junk, garbage. I've got the receipts here. You guys have seen them all. So the proposal story, for those that missed it last night. So is it bad that I can't even remember the exact day? I think it was the 25th, 26th, somewhere around there, of October last year. Is he had gone, I believe, to Wyndham. There was an issue with the truck and trying to get Jake an apartment or whatever. So he came back and I had come home from work. And I know that he wanted to make a video because Anthony Nix's new song, Because of You, was being released. So I know that he wanted to make a video about it. But that day I came home from work and he had the ring light up in the living room. And he said, oh, we're going to make a video for Anthony. So I said, okay, fine. So I went in, I brushed my hair real quick, come back out, and he was with the he was filming. I don't believe he wasn't live, but he was certainly filming, and walked out and he was down, on his knee with a box. And I thought we were just doing like a little music video. And then he opened it and I said, "Oh, is that real?" And then he's like, "Oh, you messed it up." So we had to go redo it for his video, and that was the proposal. And then, okay, I should have. Oh, geez. I wanted to call my family, all these things, my friends, everybody. And he immediately went live in the kitchen. I went on the patio and started calling people. Now, here's what I learned. What my mom told me is that he had a plan to propose long ago, had worked up a plan, with my sister and stuff, trying to figure out when to do it. And then went against all those and had to do it because he wanted to jump on this new song that was being released for his BFF at the time. You guys see how all that worked out. So anyways, that's how the proposal went. It was pretty much staged so that he can make a TikTok video. And then I kind of sat sad, and then that whole weekend, I was so sad. A lot of my friends in here know it. I was just sad because we did not celebrate. We didn't do anything. It was all about being on TikTok and him getting the congratulations from people on TikTok. And I just bebopped around. I was sad. I was really sad. But anyways, that's that story. And you guys could see it. That video looked so staged. So stage, all for the show. So yeah, that's tonight. Yeah, that's a red flag moment right there. I know we do ignore those moments. The dented hood. I was not there, so I cannot tell that story. Hi, Ginger. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know why I stayed. I don't know. You know what? I don't think somebody's gonna have to go find that video because I have all of his stuff blocked. And I believe he took them down, but it's out there somewhere. Somebody's got it. All right. That video. Oh, I looked so thrilled all the time. But anyway, so yeah, that was things that I wanted to talk about tonight. And again, you guys, we're going to post all these lives on the YouTube page. So if you missed it, please go watch it. And then also my email's up there. And if you want to reach out, please do. I would love to hear from you. I read every single message that comes through. And I can't thank you guys enough for being in here tonight. All the support has been phenomenal. There's a little bit of the hate that comes through, but like I said, I can take it. But this is hard. This is very hard to be able to do this. So I appreciate you guys actually listening to me. I really, really do. So thank you guys. We will see you tomorrow night. Everybody, take care.